Hallo, hallo, check, check, hallo. Ei, da ist ja mal jemand endlich. Ich war drauf, dass da überhaupt jemand in den Stream gekommen ist, Junge. Na jo, dann läsche mal los, ha? Jetzt mal die Männer essen. Slot 1 ist für Posse, also Slot 2. Hab ich mir doch gedacht. Das Bübsche braucht doch seinen Schönheitsschlaf.
Meanwhile, aboard the Cajun Queen, Pierre LeBlanc, known by his fellow anglers as Scaly Pete.
Daddy hunted sharks. I hunt sharks. It's in the blood. There was somebody better at this you'd be following them, yeah? Well, people got a lot of wrong ideas about sharks. Scientists say how we gotta coexist. Now, how you gonna coexist with that shark? Shark just want to do one thing. That's kill you, eat you, and you out. What I do, I consider a sacred honor. Kill them all if I could. Too bad, ain't but 24 hours to a day.
Shark spotted in Fatik Bayou. Several deaths reported. Shark can be identified by rusty harpoon embedded in flank.
The out of my way. Got a job to do.
Scheiß Reality-TV-Show aufgezogen. Leider bin ja ich.
This is an adult bull shark. Fast, fierce, and armed quite literally to the teeth, she has little to fear here in the Gulf. The muscular marvel confidently moves through its watery womb. Muscular, blunt-faced mahi-mahi is exhibiting behavior more common to a thresher shark. This bull makes creative use of her powerful tail. A shark fin is a sinister reminder to humans that the ocean remains a wild and untamed domain. The bull performs an acrobatic feat worthy of an orca, cruelly imprisoned and put on display in a marine park stunt show. The big fish plunges to the ocean below. The bull's speed is astounding for a large marine predator. Shark is a rare and calorie-intensive spectacle. A shark's tail alone can draw blood. Sharks feed on mollusks, fish, and seals. Less discussed is their propensity to feed on fear. Behind the shark's primitive caricature lurks a complex animal that perhaps, like many animals, sharks need to breathe to live. Thank you. be emphasized that this sort of targeted violence is quite unusual for a shark.
That shark needs a good whack on their nose. Go get him, Chad.
Some dinner coming, boys. Let's get her up on deck, huh?
Gosh darn it. I can't get.
On board the Cajun Queen, Scaly Pete looks over the catch of the day.
Yeah, this my daddy's iron, all right. But this ain't the shark. Not the one I was looking for.
How do you know?
How I know? Not big enough. This look like a mega to you. Oh, well, looky here. She's on for me.
Oh.
Hello. How you mama in there?
Why'd you do that?
So I can identify next time I see her, when I spear her.
The tiny pup responds with an instinct for survival.
You'll never want to turn off that camera.
I know, right? The nature documentary commentary in the background the whole time. That's the voice actor of Jerry from Rick and Morty. Oh, not this little guy, girl.
A famous big game hunter once posited that after an animal had tasted human flesh, it forsakes its natural prey in a deadly single-minded search for the most dangerous gift.
So good. Not all small.
Remember, when planning a cemetery, try to avoid high-risk coastal areas.
Ah. Open world collectathon. Oh, thank you. You're too kind.
The predatory scavenger is often quite content to dine on whatever wastes fall to the ocean floor. We are fortunate that the magic of the camera allows us to witness this savage orgy of feeding with such vividness and detail. The shark returns once again to her safe haven.
Can smell. Ooh, here we go. RPG elements.
Exhibiting behavior more common to whales and dolphins, this shark is able to use biosonar to locate potential prey. I have one of those new pop-up tub stoppers at home, and let me tell you, those things are just a magnet for hair and debris.
This.
freshwater fish commonly found throughout the Great Lakes region, so I have no idea what it's doing.
What a musky fish is in German. What thing we have to see? No, nothing cash.
Some sharks are scavengers, indiscriminately consuming anything that's vaguely edible. The sea wolf has detected vibrations in the water and is searching for their source. The bull shark is able to attain larger maximal sizes through selective feeding. Point, it needs to focus on self-care,
goodbye,
such as meditation or in-home spa treatments.
That's not gonna go okay. That's a big rock, yep. No thanks. Thank you.
In the kill or be killed world of the sea, performance-enhancing mutagens provide benefits that could mean the difference between life and death.
Let's go here.
Only here can the shark discover the miracle of self-love.
I already got a little bigger.
Cold-blooded rover moves confidently through her liquid fluid. Supercharged with gene-altering mutagens, the shark now has an asymmetric edge on the competition. Hunting of Fautix Keystone predators has led to a superabundance of catfish, which is just fine by local bully Rosie the Alligator.
Rosie the Alligator. Doesn't sound like fun at all. Let's see what we unlocked there.
The shark is now a shark. And we should expect much angst, ennui, and poor decision-making.
Oh. We're now a teenager. Hooray. Nothing else new. Could make this better. Or not. Nasty crop was.
If a group of consenting adults wants to perform cryptic rites to shadow forth the prophecy of the great old ones, who am I to judge? The situation looks dire if the big fish doesn't find water soon. An insatiable fish. The bull shark is 9/10 appetite.
And what's the other type?
Excessive and dangerous lifestyle often results in serious injury for the shark. Random mutations aren't random. They require large amounts of mutagens as a catalyst. As a result of industrial pollution and sewage wastewater, Dead Horse Lake was designated a Superfund site in 1996.
Do I need adult supervision?
Quite a strange conglomeration of stuff will end up in the stomachs. The grant from Sunshine Solutions that made this show possible. We'd also like to remind viewers that mass cloning and gene editing for today's military is safer than ever.
Oh, that's good to know.
Quiet space is the ideal stage for the Shark to meditate and harness her pure potentiality. How man's intrusion has disrupted the fragile equilibrium of the marine world.
Okay.
bull shark, there's nothing quite like dining surfside on tanned and toned beach bodies. Element.
This game is fucking stupid and awesome. I love it.
A regular there at Flamingo Joe's. You say it's a tourist trap. But it's the only place to get a decent Cesarac that don't have me on their do not serve list.
Always best for sharks to stay wet and oxygenated. Must now be killed and publicly displayed to satisfy the city's thirst for revenge.
I mean, I'm not an ornithologist, but I think it's probably a bad idea to get in the middle of the new population cycles.
Thank you.
The Scourge of the Swampland, Bayou Willie.
There we go. Looks like an idiot.
The situation has escalated, and the price on the shark's head has risen. An intensive shark hunt is now underway.
About those settings. Is it better now? Let me know.
Sometimes one can but only laugh at man's helplessness in the face of nature's vengeance. Shark versus dolphin, orca versus giant squid, boat versus pylon. When establishing dominance, the contest is usually a deadly one, with survival as the prize. Powers of society have retaliated with deterrent action, but mankind is ultimately impotent to stop Mother Nature's vengeance. Is easily identified by its squared stern and pointed bow.
Oh. just grab this and not die.
A bull shark is an animal of broad dietary proclivities.
Jeez. Combat ain't easy in this game. Ow! Jeez! Come from fucking piece of shit, Gator.
Many social movements, the annual Driftwood Man Festival purports to foster progressive change, but it's really just an excuse for hippies to flout public nudity laws.
Let's see about... getting some new stuff first. We unlock new teeth, after all.
So once more, the shark turns back to this place of centered calm.
Sounds good.
Until local police departments settle a dispute over jurisdiction, these two remain a popular attraction for selfie-seeking snorkelers.
Thank you.
this.
Oh yeah, that thing.
Fever has seized Port Clovis, making it dangerous for anything that swims.
Dead.
The compatibility of humans and carnivorous predators
okay.
is reinforced yet
okay.
again.
I get it. Not easy. Guns are pretty good at killing sharks.
Water's murkiness, or turbidity, can significantly raise the risk of a shark attack.
Well there.
Hunting sector has experienced significant growth, leaving a lot of local openings for amusement ride operators.
I really should have given them better eyes when I'm dead.
grab the boats first.
A successful shark hunt is traditionally celebrated with off-brand the bartender life in Bobby Bojangles.
Let's grab her.
Shark at a dead horse lake. Fire up a boat!
Despite increased aerial surveillance, confidence amongst tourists and locals alike is far from good. With little fanfare, another bounty hunt comes to a close. Mutagen 23 is certainly heating up the evolutionary arms race. The Barracuda's shape could be described as totally tubular. That's terrible. Have to abandon this plot thread, huh?
Gosh, this game is tough. And it didn't have difficulty sliders either. So this is the Dark Souls of shark RPGs, I guess.
Dead Horse Lake has reawakened candid public debate about human progress.
Exactly, Shark PG. Ooh, more max health. Yes, please. Can we upgrade that too? Yes. Yes. More HP. Never wrong. There we go. Now we should be able to survive some more.
Season ends, hunters return to their normal routine of bouncing checks at liquor stores. Of 73 was a magical time in Port Clovis when local favorite Trash Talk placed 20th in the Derby and the city placed first in the country for petty theft. Accustomed to feeding on a wide variety of prey, most shark hunters have close friends or family members who have been eaten or half eaten by sharks.
Shark at Dead Horse Lake.
Got another shark situation. smell unusual? Or is that just poor clothing?
Probably right under me.
Does it smell unusual, or is that just poor clothing?
The battle is over, but the war goes on.
Perfect, they respawn.
The most party parties have woven vinyl flooring. Easy to clean in case of alcohol related bouts of spontaneous diarrhea.
First.
Dead Horse Lake should be embarrassing, right? But in Port Clovis, they put up a monument. So you gotta be the best at something.
It's a shame that human and shark must so often meet. Around Trash Island, where they enjoy a steady diet of hypodermic needles and used pregnancy tests. Bounty on the line, the shark hunters get serious about finding our bull shark before kickoff.
Got it.
the hunt ends. But this is a mere pause in the eternal struggle between man and nature. Molly Hatch disturbs the serenity of an otherwise calm sea. The shark hunters are needed. This protein supplement has zero additives, so the shark doesn't have to worry about hitting artificial.
Say what you want. Them hobos, good workers. Unlike my so-called son, Kyle. That's why I pay him to stay on the lookout for that shark. Another shark hunt draws to a close. Handyman special overlooking breathtaking panoramic lake views. Open living with vintage appeal. Call Devon. From Adam. If he kill another fisherman, that's between them and him, yeah?
Fuck this boat.
From the moment she's born, the shark's cold, expressionless eyes are constantly on the watch for food. Thank you. I would like to assure the Antolini crime family that this footage will in no way be used in the final edit of our program. Sharks consume quite a variety of revolting and unmentionable things. The shark returns once again to her safe haven.
Bunch of resources, so why not? Enough. Better. Now, where do we want to go?
Of a shark is acutely aware that they'll eat just about anything. Shark demonstrates the importance of getting enough minerals in her diet. Thank you. find a home near the retired nuclear cooling towers. This is a great opportunity for the shark to test the theory that exposure to gamma rays gives you superpowers. Remains acutely aware of anything that might constitute food.
Okay.
Artist spent 16 years building this sculpture out of trash pulled from the lake, only to have it thrown back in the lake by intoxicated locals. Sailors, sharks can uncork a load of surprises. Thank you. Bubba Fondo and the Barracuda Boys were voted Port Clovis's best party band 3 years running. Curiously, none of the boys are actual Barracudas.
Let's head back here and do stuff here.
According to the county administrator, Chuck Hucklebridge, the lack of effectiveness of piecemeal technocratic solutions here can only be solved with more piecemeal technocratic solutions.
Okay, good to know. More health. Hey there. Much about the mic gain. There we go. So, let's see. There we go. See you later, alligator. Dire level problem there. Still to pick.
Would hardly be the strangest thing ever retrieved from a crocodile's mouth.
Ah, and here. Captain Hook reference. Crocodile and Clark Kent.